Hey kids, today's story takes place on top of a mountain. Now, if you're standing on top of a mountain, you can see more things than if you were on the ground. In today's story, three of Jesus's closest friends see something miraculous on top of a mountain. Now, before we find out what they saw, let's think about our big picture question. So our big picture question is, why did Jesus perform miracles? And remember, a miracle is something that is normally impossible, but when it's done in God's power, it is possible. So Jesus performed miracles to glorify God, to show that he is the Son of God, and to care for people. When Jesus did impossible things, it proved that he had power over creation. It demonstrated that he is the Son of God, and he also used miracles to meet people's needs for food, healing, and safety. Okay. Before we read our story, let's review what we've learned this unit. So our very first story, we learned that Jesus calmed a storm to show that he is God. He protected his disciples from sinking and showed his power. Next, we saw how Jesus miraculously fed a crowd with 5 loaves and 2 fish. In this story, Jesus was showing compassion on hungry people and proving that he is God. Then last week, we saw how Jesus showed he was God by walking on water. During this story, all the disciples worshiped him and glorified him as God. This week, we're going to look at a story called Jesus Showed His Glory.
Hi guys, it's Daniel here with today's story. Jesus Showed His Glory. This can be found in Matthew 17, Mark 9, and Luke 9. One day, Jesus led 3 of his disciples, Peter, James, and John, up on a high mountain to pray. The disciples fell fast asleep. As Jesus prayed, his appearance suddenly changed. His face was shining like the sun, and his clothes were as white as light. The disciples woke up, and they saw Moses and Elijah talking with Jesus. Peter said, "Lord, it is good for us to be here. If you want, I'll set up 3 tents here, one for you, and one for Moses, and one for Elijah." While Peter was still speaking, a bright cloud suddenly covered them. A voice from the cloud said, "This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to him." The disciples heard this and fell face down. They were terrified. Jesus came up and touched them. "Get up," he said. "Don't be afraid." When the disciples looked up, they did not see Moses or Elijah anymore. They only saw Jesus. As they were coming down the mountain, Jesus said to them, "Don't tell anyone what you saw until the Son of Man is raised from the dead." The disciples did not tell anyone, but they wondered what Jesus meant. They asked him, "Why did the scribes say that Elijah must come before the Messiah comes?" Jesus explained that Elijah had already come, that is, a prophet like Elijah had come. The people did not recognize Jesus as a prophet, and they mistreated him. Jesus said, "In the same way, the Son of Man is going to suffer at their hands." Then the disciples realized Jesus was talking about John the Baptist.
In this story, Jesus showed his glory to Peter, James, and John, 3 of his closest friends. Now, this story is found in Matthew 17, Mark 9, and Luke 9. And in each story, we see a little bit more detail about what happened on the mountain. So Mark wrote that Jesus's clothing was whiter than any person could get them, no matter how he or she washed them. Matthew explained that Jesus's face shone like the sun. It would have been an incredible sight. Jesus's glory is bright and intense, but it's more than just light. So Jesus's glory is sort of like a combination of many wonderful things about him. His glory shows his goodness. It shows his love, his holiness, his fame, his endlessness. It is all the majesty of his power. Jesus is the greatest treasure in the world. Jesus is more than a good man or a wise teacher. He is the Son of God. The Bible tells us that he is the image of the invisible God. He is the King of all kings. All things were created by him and for him. Without Jesus, all creation could no longer exist. When Peter, James, and John saw Jesus in his glory, they saw who Jesus really is more clearly than they ever had before. Remember, God's plans and actions are perfect and righteous. We can praise Him for doing what is best. And that's exactly what our key passage reminds us of. This is our last week with this key passage. And our key passage is Psalms 45, which says, "You have multiplied, O Lord my God, your wondrous deeds and your thoughts towards us. None can compare with you. I will proclaim and tell of them, yet they are more than can be told." So let's practice our key passage one more time. One day, Jesus will come back to earth in His glory to make all things new. This story tells us of the first time Jesus revealed His glory to humans, but it will not be the last time humans see Jesus' glory. When Jesus returns to earth wearing bright white clothing and shining brighter than the sun, He will destroy all evil and fix everything wrong in the world. Everyone who has faith in Jesus will receive new glorified bodies to live forever with God. If you have any questions about that, talk to your parents or talk to me. As always, your activity sheets are uploaded. Go tell somebody what you learned this week, and we'll see you soon.
One day, Jesus led three of His disciples, Peter, James, and John, up on a high mountain to pray. The disciples fell fast asleep. As Jesus prayed, His appearance suddenly changed. His face was shining like the sun, and His clothes were as white as the light. The disciples woke up and saw Moses and Elijah talking with Jesus. Peter said, "Lord, it is good for us to be here. If you want, I will set up three tents here, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah." While Peter was still speaking, a bright cloud suddenly covered them. A voice from the cloud said, "This is my beloved Son, with whom I am well pleased. Listen to Him." The disciples heard this and fell face down. They were terrified. Jesus came up and touched them. "Get up," He said. "Don't be afraid." When the disciples looked up, they did not see Moses or Elijah anymore. They only saw Jesus. As they were coming down the mountain, Jesus said to them, "Don't tell anyone what you saw until the Son of Man is raised from the dead." The disciples did not tell anyone, but they wondered what Jesus meant. They asked him, "Why do the scribes say that Elijah must come before the Messiah comes?" Jesus explained that Elijah had already come. That is, a prophet like Elijah had come. The people did not recognize him as a prophet and they mistreated him. Jesus said, "In the same way, the Son of Man is going to suffer at their hands." Then the disciples realized Jesus was talking about John the Baptist. Jesus showed his glory to Peter, James, and John. Jesus said he would die, rise from the dead, and return to heaven. One day, Jesus will come back to earth in his glory to make all things new.